Okay, so this is the picture for tonight. Not quite as I would have imagined, but you know, it's not bad. I'll walk you through it. I guess you've probably already seen the setup video for it. So you got that picture. We have that picture of the Sunny D bottle. And then Nick bowing down to it. So for this one, I up the clarity, vibrance, shadows, exposure. So we'll run through those. So first for the exposure, this is the before, after, before, after. So we're a little bit dark. So we're brightening it up, brightened everything up. That's half a stop. Where is that 0.9? So it's almost a full stop brighter. So everything got a little brighter. We also brighten the highlights just to bring it out more with this. See, there's not really any pop anywhere. It's kind of, it's a little bit flat. There's no white. So I brought out the highlights a little bit. We increase that with clarity. So without clarity, see, there's not much definition in the midtones. But with clarity, it drags this section. The midtones this way and makes them brighter, so it brings up the highlights in the floor and his pants and all that fun stuff. And vibrance just adds more color. So with this one, I pretty much apply the same settings except I drop the highlights a little bit so that the bottle of sanity wasn't so overblown. So now into editing. Let's start out from the beginning. So we got our background black. Then we've got Nick. So with Nick, I use this layer mask. So the background, the darker it is, the less it's being seen. So without it, see the chair and all that, and then with it, it's just barely, barely there. So I wanted it to mostly go away. Then we added in the little reflection. So without the layer mask, it's this picture. But then I added this layer mask. So a little bit of white will make it visible, and then the black is what's not visible. You can see. It's just barely there. I wanted that little bit of reflection in for the bottle, make it a little bit more believable. Then let's see, I think I added, so that's this. So how did I make that? What I did is I made streaks of this gold paint, originating from that point, just kind of like that, and then with my mouse. Then I went to filter, blur, radial blur, and then zoom. So you see what it does to these, I guess, light rays or points. All these were points originally. So it's right here, which is centered over this. You can just drag that around to wherever you want. It's a good blur amount, and it has to be set to zoom. Spin does that. Zoom does that. So I did that a lot of times for this. I kept layering in small brush strokes, like you can see this one here, big brush strokes like this big blur right here, and then small ones, but long. I just layered, kept layering that, blurring it, paint some more in with a different brush size, blur it, etc. until I got this, which has a focal point there, which I put the bottle of sanity on to make it blend in a little more. So right there, it's kind of a little bit of a glow. There we go. So that outer glow, double click, brings up this layer style. Click outer glow. And then I chose the color from here. Turn the opacity up a little bit, it's default at 70. Turn the size up, and then spread. So I'll give you this, and it helps blend in with this a little bit. So I'm at this point, kind of looks like it's just the 2D thing. So, first thing I did was add this reflection on the wall. Just have that. No, I wish I could make it better. I couldn't find one that really did it justice. There's overlay, which gotta turn this off. So overlay does that. Soft light. Still, you can see I'm still messing with it. I think linear light does the best. So you know what I can do that might help a bit. I'm gonna go that. Gum brush. Brush B. B. Change the black. Big. Change the opacity 30%. And just paint over here. It's definitely not good. Zoom in here once it decides to move. Okay. No, guys. Stop zooming. That's alright. It's super light. Okay. I'm going to go brush it smaller. And opacity up to like 80. And just not that much. How about 40? And just go like this. We're just going to go. Go in here. Yes. So what I'm doing right now is I'm painting in the shadows. So the light is the shadow, and light obviously doesn't apply to the shadows as much as it does to the highlights. So by painting in the shadows, hopefully I'll make this more believable, like it isn't just a painting on there in Photoshop. Which it is, but you know. I also don't have a lot of time to do this. So let's go filter. We'll try that. So Gaussian blurring on mask. So before, you see the sharp edges. After, blur them a little bit. So yeah, that helps. This pops out a little bit more. And it helps add to that feeling of 3Ds. So that's popping in a little bit. And with this, I could go and paint in every single one, but I'm not gonna do that. So I'm just gonna go right like this. And go over these shadows. Except for over that grate, which, you know, look. Okay. So we get that. That's I don't know what would happen if I just did. No. So, no reflection. And I also added in this main light, or this main light. this reflection in the floor. So what I did for this was I took this, flipped it vertically, moved it down, and then used perspective control, which is in Edit, Transform Perspective, and line that so it looks like it's coming up from the floor more, if that makes sense. So the center is now here. It's maybe about where it would be, I guess. And it's just to add something to the floor to make it look, again, a little bit more realistic. I get to reflect the golf before. And then finally, added in this glow when it's back on the wall a little bit on the floor. What I did for this was I painted a really soft opacity, 10% maybe gold, just over his back, his cap and stuff where he would be being hit by light. And then I came back in and filled in some of these shadows with black on the layer mask. So you can look at the layer mask. I don't know if I can see it right there. Maybe that's not as effective. But I painted in black over these wrinkles in the shirt. So let's just see how I can put this up. Is it doing anything? I think it is. I'm just kidding, so that. Tricky. Okay, there we go. Now you can see. So there's what I painted in black. So let's go select all our mask levels. Let's drag that up a bit. That, then I'm going to go Command F to blur that, and up again. So that's without a layer mask. It's with. I don't think I like that one. There we go. Okay. So just slightly highlighting his back. And I think that was the last edit for this one. So let's save that. Sure. So that's going to take a while because it's. And go to the Lightroom. Yeah. And there we go. I don't think I'm going to do any edits on this since I did most of it in Photoshop. And it looks pretty good in Lightroom. I wish, again, would have had this more believable. I had more time, I would spend a little research and figure out how to get this reflect off the walls or make it look a little better. In the layer, fill it with black, which is Alt Delete if your foreground color is black. Go filter, render, lens flare. Put it in there. Screen. Wow, this is incredible. Remove it. Not that much. soft brush. Get rough edges around a bit. Trimming. Okay. We'll just stick that behind. Or the same idea. Just move those down a little bit. Yes. You see that vertical line? Not sure what that is, but it's part of this. I'll just go like that. Okay. That looks pretty good. That's before. We'll call that the finished project. Product apart from just a little bit more on this. I'm not sure what. Hold on. This is getting a little bit of some vertical line right there. Right. Well, I'll get rid of that and call it good because my computer's probably about to explode from all this processing.